This is Jay Essence. I'm doing another video for you. Once again, another disclaimer. If you're hearing all kind of sounds and everything, it is my fault. I was just so determined to give you guys like a different atmosphere. I wanted you to kind of see some of the landscape and just be outside, because being outside here in Kigali is absolutely beautiful. However, where I'm staying, they're actually building a here in Kigali is absolutely beautiful. However, where I'm staying, they're actually building across the street and they're preparing for a wedding downstairs. So like, this was absolutely probably the worst timing for me to do this, but I wanted to make sure it got done. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the things that you need to pack that you didn't know you needed to pack in order to come to Rwanda or Kigali. And these are purely opinion, is what I think. You don't have to listen to me. You can do life on your own merit and terms. You can do what you wanna do, boo. It's all, you can do what you wanna do in living color, hey. All right, so I do have a list down here that I'm kind of looking at every once in a while. And I am going to tell you just in my 1 week what I have kind of recognized and realized and come across. So the very first thing I wanted to talk about is grip. You need to bring something that grips for your feet. And what I mean by this is like, okay, sister girls, when we pack, we got outfits to take this picture in, and we got these shoes to go here, and these shoes to go where, and all that other stuff. I am going to tell you right now, you need sneakers. You don't even need tennis shoes. Tennis shoes might not have a, you need sneakers. Sneakers are built with the idea of grabbing ground, because you ain't talented enough in the calf, knees, or ankles to do the walking you need to do without having a slip or fall. And you know those little cute shoes. I ain't endorsing nobody, but if you got them little kids and you gonna slip or slide, you gonna slip and slide, baby. You gonna slip and slide. You're gonna surfboard all up and down these streets of Kigali, and you just gonna be gone. And let me tell you something. Have you ever done, what's the slip and slide, or you go into like the water parks and they have the little thing, and when you slide, you just gone? There ain't no stopping point. It ain't no little patch to help you. If you gonna slide, you gone down the whole hill. Just rolling and tumbling, tumbling and rolling. So you need some grip. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna look at videos of other people, and you're gonna recognize, you see people with flip-flops, sandals, just super cute. You ain't got the skills yet to be on that level. There's levels to this walking thing. You at level one, unless you coming from San Francisco and you done did hills and mountains and climbed, or you about that treacherous life or whatever, you ain't got the skills. If I had known, I would have packed more cute shoes that are like sneakers, like I said, that got that grip. And I would have packed more of those so they could go with the outfits. Then I would have had me a little handbag and flip out shoes once I get there. But you ain't about that life. And some of the streets are like rock streets and they're really cute. You ain't about that life. You not about that life. Get the grips. Brothers, you coming in with the church shoes, you gonna slide straight through. Straight through, straight to next week. Can't say I didn't warn you. So if you're gonna bring something, make sure you have considered your shoes with grip. I'm telling you. All right, number two. I showed you in my video about the studio. If you're coming into like a hotel situation, unless you're going to a house, I would definitely bring your adapter, because you don't know exactly when you're going to be able to get out and about. And I showed you some of those things. Not saying they're not here in Kigali, they're all over the place probably, but just that first day or two, if you have so much stuff that you want to plug in and everything like that, you don't want to be without. You want to make sure you have all of those things right there so you can be able to touch it. But go back and watch my video where I talk about the studio that I'm staying, because I really talk about it in detail. But definitely, I think that's one of the best things I have come across that I brought on accident so far, hands down. All right, next one, I think I'm at number 3. Brothers, how you feel? Sisters, you all right? Because I got to talk to my sisters for a second. Listen, ladies. Look, right here. This is me and you, this is personal. Bring your shorts, but not quite yet. Let me tell you what I mean by this. We're gonna have us a moment. If you thicken the thighs, and you put them shorts on, and you ain't got that slather, that's when you go like this. Not a pinch, a slather of Vaseline, that grip, you know that rub is there. Do not play games. We know about the thigh rub, that thigh burn. You do not need to burn up your life trying to be cute because you decided to do some shorts and you did not know the amount of walking you was going to do. You better get that Vaseline, bring a tub of Vaseline if you bring the shorts. I'm just telling you, they go together. They go together. But you don't want to be walking through these streets. You don't want to be walking trying to get a little taxi or walking trying to be cute. And you, this right here, act like you don't know. So that's that moment. You better bring you a slather. Get the tub of Vaseline, not the little tub. Because it's going to take you a while to get used to this. Now, I guarantee you, Jesus is going to be your personal trainer. It's gonna tighten up, it's gonna firm up, but you gotta give it time. And you don't wanna be dealing with being on the sideline because your thighs done got burnt up and you can't walk and you uncomfortable. So either get you some cushion to go in between there or put your little Vaseline. But don't be doing this thing bare bone. Mm-mm, don't do it. Do not, can't say I didn't warn you, okay? What else did I say you need to bring? Okay, so there is this store. I am not endorsing it. And I think if you check my Instagram, I might have posted a little bit on there, but it's called T2000. Basically, let me tell you what, I am not a shopper. So I'm a Walmart baby. I like going to Walmart, going through and getting everything and going home. And so T2000 is pretty much like that store out here. So if you're out here and you just need to grab some things, like I had to grab hangers, I had to grab an extra waste basket, laundry basket, I had to grab those things, so I just went there. Now I've gone walking and I've noticed, oh, there's a little side shop over here that has a laundry basket, there's such and such over here that has a bandana. And the thing that's different is so far that shops kind of specialize in their own thing. So if you need an assortment of stuff, you gotta go to different shops. So the T2000 just works if you just need to grab a lot of things. Now, I'm not the only person who said it. It's probably not my most favorite place to go because it's hectic, and I'm not here to talk negative about anything. It gets the job done. So get the job done. And I think in hindsight, if I were to ever go, I would probably go first thing in the morning. Like I went like at 7 o'clock at night, which probably is just worse, and I'm that type of person. I would kind of go first thing in the morning and grab what you need to grab and go. Now they have the assortment, they've got stuff. So you can just kind of peruse and figure it out. And it's like 2 full levels. And even in there, you're gonna do a workout. If you have to walk that ramp with your basket, somebody post below if they've done it. That is a workout. Trying to get the basket up the ramp and bringing it down without losing it. You'll figure that out. All right, let me say this. I think this is kind of weird, but you definitely need this. You need some space to adjust your mindset. And I didn't realize I needed that, and it was nothing bad. It's just that things are at a different pace, especially if you're coming from America, and I was coming from a situation where I was working, running like this. Ain't nobody running like that out here. Everything takes its time, everything's in a place, and it just, you have to have that space to be able to adjust, you know? And I can sit there and say that might be me, because I always was too fast for my britches or whatever that they used to say, and my family even looks at me like, do you have enough stuff to do? Because I always am running like this. And so it takes me a minute to say, okay, I'm gonna slow down, and it's actually a good thing. Oh my God, this view, I'm gonna show you just this landscape in a minute. Like, this is just gorgeous. I can look at these flowers all day. But you just need space. Give yourself space to adjust. Some people come down and love it. Some people come down and just need... And I think you need time to explore. There are so many different places, even though it's small, to be able to go and find your niche. So just make sure you give yourself space to do that. And patience. You're going to need some patience. You're going to need some patience. Like me getting my bank account was almost 2 hours. And there was nothing wrong, it just was almost 2 hours. And so just get your little water, have your headphones in. Just things do not move as fast as we're used to. Speaking of fast, an adjustment. Nothing you need to bring, but you're going to have to adjust to the idea of there's no fast food. And that sounds good to a lot of you. I know you're like, oh my gosh, yes, everything's natural, everything's good. I love it. I love the fact there's no fast food until I find myself in a habit that I haven't had a chance to break. And my habit is I am a workaholic. So I work and my body tends to get hungry between, I get the nudge at 5, I'm ready to kill somebody at 6, like right there. So as a workaholic, I could always work till 5 or whatever, get up, go home, drive through, grab something, pick up something, and then go. So that piece, if I'm wanting to eat a meal, it has to be cooked. And first of all, I have yet 7 days, 7 whole days, and not no bad food at all. 7 whole days. 7 whole days, everything, every place I've gone, anything I've had, great, loved it. It is so good. But you have to give people time to cook. Even like I used to be like hungry and be like, okay, I'm gonna get an appetizer or just bring me out some fries. And the lady that I talked to was like, fries take 15 minutes. And I was like, oh, okay. So it's more so an adjustment on my end. And I actually love it. I just have to adjust. But pretty much no fast food. There is a KFC. I have not experienced that life yet. I will be checking it out. But just kind of know or adjust. And then if you're living here, you're gonna be okay. If you're visiting, just know you plan out your meals, or just don't be like me, because when I'm hungry, I'm hungry and it's about to go down. Like everybody else has different temperaments. 6 o'clock, my temperament is not no more. Mm-mm. 6 o'clock, my temperament is feed me now. So like I said, I'm adjusting and I need to make sure that's me. I drink enough water, because I don't drink enough water, which also causes my body to be like, feed me now. So that's it. Just giving you that heads up. Bring your smile. Yes! Like a smile breaks so many doors and gathering. There's no need to be upset. There's no need to be frustrated. There's a lot of people everywhere. But smile, it's there. You can do it. And also your smile is not, and I think that's something where we didn't realize, sometimes you can't trust everybody who smiles in your face, you know, like people, you know, smile in your face, talk behind your back, and we're coming from that lifestyle, and so we kind of sometimes look at things skeptically. You can be you. You can just be you. Smile at people, wave. If people are staring at you, wave. Don't take a stare down like, who you looking at? That's not what it is. You're probably different. You're probably whatever it is. People just look. But it's nothing to be like, they was looking at me. They was looking. No, it's not. It's not that. Smile, wave, and find your own rhythm and get relaxed. Now I gotta look at the paper to see. I hit that, I hit that, I hit that, I hit that, I hit that. Oh, two more things. For my sisters with the hair, there is one store I've seen so far that has As I Am. They got the double butter, girl. They got the double butter. Now, you're not gonna find it in your regular grocery store. You're not gonna find it just anywhere. But there was like a mall I went to eat. I passed the shop, bam, right there. And they had a line. They had As I Am. I should have taken a picture. If I go back, I'll take a picture. They had the hair care stuff that we're looking for. Now I'm going to tell you this. I promise you, it's going to cost a grip. I promise you, just because how the store looked, and just how things are. But if you ever had that double butter and they had to leave in, I'll be all right. But that makes me happy. That makes me happy. So they had a couple other lines, and I'll go back and check and see. But that premium natural hair care stuff, there's something here. Because I didn't even find that in when I was in the UAE. So just there is somebody who knows that the double butter is important, and I will be taking care of that person. And so because of that, you're gonna have to be able to be patient. I will be honest, there's been a couple of power outages, and let me tell you how the power outages moves. Like the first power outage, I was like, oh, everybody else was like, so you were saying, like they didn't even flinch, they took it, ah, bah. And so by the next one, I even had one in the bank. I just knew things were gonna shut down, like chink, 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 chink. They on a generator, they kept on going, no problem. So, so far, or at least where I'm at, power outages happen, but they have always happened simultaneously to me with the weather and the lights come back on. So you just have to have patience. Just take it like, open up a window, keep on going, find something else to do. Things happen, you'll survive. You've been through worse. Trust and believe. If you ever stood in a financial aid line at an HBCU, you got this. You got this. You can do it. You know what patience is. Be patient. Okay? Ask questions. I have always found every single question I've asked has been answered with a smile. I have not seen like I've infringed on anybody. So just ask questions. Ask questions below. Build a community. And so all of those things are possible. So I don't know if this is really what you need to pack or what you need to know before coming out here. It's just a little video to just give you a little tidbit or two or three. At least from my travels, is that the right word? Because I'm not traveling. My stay here. So, I think that's it. Pretty much hit all of the things that I thought I was gonna hit. Y'all, the food is good. Oh, bring grits. Especially, let me tell you some things. Bring grits and bring your Tony saturates. And not that you need it. It's just, let's be honest, we coming in with that high blood pressure, it takes us a minute to wean off. So if you just need to get you a hit, bring a small one. You just might have to go inside someday and just get a hit. Like I had a little cucumber tomato salad, it was really good, but my body was calling for just a little tap of that seasoning salt, and you ain't gonna find it here. So just go ahead and bring your grits, bring your seasoning salt, bring whatever your little staples to make you feel like you have home right there in your environment for you. So that was it. I'm about to enjoy some of this beautiful weather. Okay, so this is gonna be a janky moment because I'm gonna go to the camera and turn it around so you can see the greenery. This is gorgeous. Like, yeah, I'm gonna probably be moving my chair because I always look this way. Because I don't know if you can see like the hill. I always look this way. I'm probably gonna be moving it and looking. Who cooking? Oh, they cooking down. Oh, I smell it. Let me go find out who getting married and get me a plate. Okay, let me turn it around real quick. Can you see it? Like, this is really hot. Because I'm on the tripod trying to show you. But like, these are individual flowers and trees, so that's why this is gorgeous. Okay, focus, baby. There you go. Let me see if I can get nosy. Okay. They don't know I'm filming them. Be quiet. Say nothing. Something cooking. Woo! So good. Let me give you the whole aspect. I think I've done this for you before.